Hi everyone, Jeff from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now last week I was doing some mowing with the finishing mower, the Koroni TC590, and then during mowing I heard a weird sound. Now I'm not sure about you, but when I'm doing some tractor work I don't like to hear weird sounds. So I stopped, took up the mower deck and looked underneath, and yes, I saw two of the blades not rotating properly anymore. So I stopped immediately, put it back in the workshop and took open the cover. And I saw that the V-belts were completely broken. Now, I brought this mower deck 18 years ago, brand new, and I never replaced the V-belt. So these were still the original V-belts, so I'm not going to complain at all. I think I did a proper job, but now I needed to replace them. So I ordered some new ones on the internet. They came in a few days ago, and I will show you how I repaired the mower deck.
It's already raining all day, so it's really low countries weather, and that's a good time to repair some front material. Now I cleaned it up a little so that you're not working in the dirt. Now you have to be a little bit smart putting on the V-belts, because this pulley is lower than that pulley. So this is the lower belt, this is the higher belt. This one has the opening at the top, this one has the opening at the bottom. So when I put on this belt, then when I want to do that one afterwards, it has to cross that feed belt. It's not possible. So the only way to do that is that I first put on this belt on the drive, and then later put it on the center blade like this. Yeah. So, and now let's see if I can get the lower belt over the axis over here, and that will be a difficult task, I think, but let's see. Now the nuts at the bottom side are welded to this cover plate, so in that sense, apparently I'm still able to unscrew them, which is nice, because I was a little bit afraid that they would be too much corroded to take them out. With those both screws away, I can now move up this plate a little bit. And that's enough to put the V-belts in between the cover plate and the top side of this shaft. So that's a good thing. Now the V-belts are now in place. I just need to put them on the pulley, of course, but they went over the axis. So I will grease up the bolts and put them back, because when I need to replace them again in 18 years from now, then they will be easily taken off. I don't want to think how old I am over 18 years, but not even sure. I'll be there then, but let's see. At least my bolts are greased. Now the next step is to move this a little bit to this side, so the distance becomes shorter for the for the V-belts, so I can put them on and then put them back on tension. So I have to release these nuts and then screw this a little bit forward. All the belts are now in its proper location, so I can put the whole system back onto tension again. Don't forget to secure the setting using this lock nut. Now the tension is quite okay. I'm almost back at the original setting, so that's good. Yeah, that's fine. Of course, secure these bolts again. And then put on the cover. Then it's ready for the next 18 years of mowing. And since we have it here anyway, let's also grease the joints. Ready to go for another 18 years of mowing.
So the Krony has now new V-belts, so I expect it to last again for 18 years, we'll see. But I can enjoy my mowing again. Always be careful about your hearing, so I always wear these earplugs during mowing, and that makes it even more relaxed work than it already is. Thanks for watching. If you like the channel, please subscribe. We'd appreciate that, and see you next time.